What's up, ViteConf? My name is Atila. I'm the X lead at Crab Nebula, and I'm part of the Tauri working group and Solid DX team. As you may have guessed by the frameworks I use, I really love Vite. I think it allows us to ship high quality apps while giving our users the best developer experience. So today, I'm here to return the favor. At Crab Nebula, we're very passionate about Tauri. We really believe it is the best alternative to create desktop and mobile apps with web tech. So much so, we have created a cloud to help you deploy, publish, and scale those apps with as little effort as you can imagine. And today, I'm here to show you the next step on this mission. We call it Taurify. So let's say you just finished creating your app. It might be a simpler demo app like the Solid Hacker News, or a more complete app like Elk, the Next-based client for Mastodon. So once the web app is done, now is the time you bring Taurify into your stack and get ready to ship a native app. As its most reduced form, Taurify is an SDK. So you can use it as a package or a crate to work with your app in development mode. Once you're ready to ship, it's going to use the deployed versions or services to build your production-grade app. And it does a little bit more than just wrapping your app in Tauri. It brings a bunch of optimizations and quality of life improvements. For example, it creates a release profile to optimize your bundle size and make sure you ship as less kilobytes over the wire as possible. It adds Crab Nebula DevTools, which is our open source project to help you debug and profile your app as if it was a web app, but it plugs to the Rust runtime. It adds push updates with our auto updater service, and it has release management with our cloud. Plus, we have our brand new crate, Tauri plugin OTA. OTA stands for over-the-air updates, and it can reduce the total build time from minutes to seconds for all the platforms. The reason this plugin is so fast is because it can update your JavaScript code without rebuilding the entire Rust code. This reduces the time for each platform from minutes to all platforms in seconds. But talk is cheap, so let me show you how it actually works. Mind you though, this is a pre-release, which means things are bound to get better before the end of this year, 2024. If you're interested in that, we love your feedback. It's ready to be used on dev mode, so reach out to me if you have any doubts, questions, or feedback, please. So here we are with our Solid Hacker News demo already open, the code base on one side and the browser desktop on another. As you can see, it's a solid start app. And we just have a bunch of routes, basically like any other web app. If I run the dev mode, you'll be able to see our Hacker News demo working. So one of the things we might want to do is create a Taurify JSON. And in this Taurify JSON, we can establish the name of our app, a version for us to deploy, some descriptions, and if we want to deploy it to Crab Nebula Cloud, we can set up our orgs lug and our apps lug. And then in the app, we have some customizations that we can do, like we can establish an icon for this app, and we can make some configs to the window that we're going to open. Lastly, we can add the targets to which we're going to build. And that's pretty much everything that we need to do. So now I can then, I stop the server. Nothing is running at this time. And we can then run our Taurify in dev mode. This is going to build our app again and then create the Tauri version. So if I refresh this page, it's still listening to the same localhost, which means that they are existing in sync. So if I open my CSS and I change anything here, it's going to reflect immediately with hot module replacement. So let's say Solid.js changed its brand colors and all works the same way. Now I'm done with my development. And what I can do then is come over here, stop the dev server, and now I want to ship this. So instead of running Taurify dev, I'm going to run Taurify build. And this is going to trigger the build of my app, and it's going to trigger then the build of my Tauri app and push it to Crab Nebula Cloud. And so if I open my cloud dashboard, I can see my release here and I can download the packaged version. This is just a demo app. So what we need to do now is see it with a real world app. So let's swap code bases. So now we are in a much bigger code base. This is Elk, the client for Mastodon built with Nuxt. So it has a bunch of routes and components. It's a pretty complete app. I can run the dev server again. And you can see Elk's working. Then again, the same thing as before, we can open our Taurify JSON, and then we need to set, we can create a product name. The unique identifier is something that's required to ship the apps. And in this example, I'm only building for macOS this time. So let's bump the version one more time. And let's get started with our development build first. So we can use npm dlx or npx and we run it. So as you can see, it already starts the Tauri shell while it's still building the Nuxt app. So as you can see, both apps are in sync. And for example, if I go to my translations and I say that hot module replacement works, both of them happen at the same time. And now we are ready to ship. So what we're going to do is the same thing as before. Instead of dev, we run build. And this is going to build the Nuxt app, it's going to build the Tauri app, and it's going to connect to Crab Nebula Cloud, draft a release. Once the build is done, it's going to publish the release, and then we're going to be good to go. So you can see right now, I have some previous releases already published. And with the magic of editing, I'm going to make our own release, our build to finish, and our release to be there. And there we are, release 032, and all good for macOS Silicon. I hope you have enjoyed these demos. Make sure to join our waiting list, and I'll see you around. It was a pleasure. Bye, ViteConf.